Alright everybody, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I want to check out another short horror film. This one is called Warnings, okay? And it is by That's a Bad Idea. Yes, that's the name of the channel. If you guys want to go ahead and check them out, go ahead and click in the link in the description down below this video, and you guys can find their original source right there, or their original video there. And go to the channel, give them a subscribe, like I did here, because this one looks very intriguing. The thumbnail looks very, very good, and I cannot wait to see this one here. Now, before I get into it though, let me know your thoughts down below at the end of this video in the comment section. You guys, don't be hesitant to share. If you guys have suggestions or recommendations, please also drop them down below and let me know what you recommend me to watch. All right, other than that though, I just wanted to say thank you also for those who have subscribed and who have commented. Thank you guys so much. It really means a lot to me that you have subscribed to the channel. I'm really thankful that this is very entertaining for you guys. It just does exist to me, so I'm always having fun doing this. But yeah, let's go ahead and jump into this, you guys, and I'll give you guys my thoughts right after. Let's get scared.
The walk symbol's on, I start crossing the street, and out of nowhere, sharp left turn, this white SUV is going like 70 miles per hour. The tires are making like this horrible noise. I pull like a ninja move to dive like out of the way. I swear, I had to like dive. It was like straight out of an action movie. My heart was fucking racing, dude. I cheated death right there. Gives you this crazy appreciation for like every step you take, like you dodged a cosmic bullet or something. No, that was a near-death experience, dude. Oh, I'm appreciative. I'm gonna appreciate the fuck out of this party. Hold on. What the fuck? Someone left a note on my car. Says I'm begging you to stop. Hold on. You know who it probably was? Joseph.
Oh yeah?
Joseph.
Why would Joseph do it?
Because he's trying to fuck with me. Because he fucking hates me.
I don't think he'd do that. It's not like Joseph.
Then who?
What did it say again?
Who did that?
What did it say? Please stop?
He said, I'm begging you to stop. I have it. Look. Look.
Okay, well, did you park in somebody's parking space, or...?
No.
Sure?
Well, no, because it's all public parking over there.
Yeah, but the signs, you know, they can get pretty confusing sometimes.
No, there's no private property. Over, it's all street parking.
You know, Reagan's bringing Ashley tonight. It'll be good to see her. And if Reagan gets too fucked up again, man, I'm gonna be so fucking pissed. Seriously. Jack's bringing some dice. Haley's bringing 50 jello shots. You know that?
50.
It's gonna be freaking crazy, dude.
50 jello shots.
Bro.
What's up? I did note.
Who the fuck cares? Come on.
It's weird. It's you have to admit it's weird.
It's a Halloween prank.
Well, then they got me.
How?
Because I'm freaked out.
Dang. Everybody came in now?
All right.
Good night, Sean.
Guys.
Love you.
Love you,
get
too.
Get home safe, okay?
Oh, shut the fuck up.
No, not the loser, because we are the champions.
Still bothering him. That would bother me too. If I saw something like that, I'd be like, what did I do to somebody? What? What in the world? Yeah. Okay, so...
Hey, Reagan.
Sean.
Hey, Sean.
Dude, Kendall.
What's up, Sean?
Momo. So, he's gotten two notes so far.
There's
and both of them are stopping
note.
Him from...
Hello?
But phone, dude, this time something. The note was inside my car.
Wait, what note? What
just
note?
On the front seat.
Are you serious?
Reagan, earlier, I found a handwritten note, like, outside of my car.
Wait, dude, that's
and then just now, I found another note inside my car.
What did it say?
What the fuck?
It says, please don't drive your car.
Oh, Jesus shit. Christ.
I mean, it's probably Joseph.
That's what I said.
Joseph in Seattle.
Dude, that's freaky as fuck.
It I want to be Joseph
because
now.
Because I left my iPad in the car, and they're not stealing anything. They just are writing notes.
I don't know, dude.
I mean, it's probably... It just call Joseph.
See what Joseph has to say.
Yo, yo!
Hey, where are you at?
Right now I'm at a bar in Redmond.
Oh, really?
I told the group chat I was going to Seattle.
You know, I really wanted to see you.
Wait, what are y'all doing?
No, Joseph, like, I wanna see you alone.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, too bad you're
in Seattle.
Too
many of my speakies.
Fuck! Well, I get back on Wednesday.
It's not Joseph.
Dang, dude. It's really getting to him. Look at him.
Shot. Come on in.
I love that. Oh, God. I felt like a transition to something else, but it was just him blinking his, like, going to sleep. That was really good.
Let's talk about
these slowly
notes.
Fading to sleep. What?
These notes, they might mean something.
What do you mean?
Well, obviously they don't have an origin.
It's a really cool mask.
Wait, no, they do have an origin.
Oh, that's right! They do have an origin.
Yeah.
We just don't know the origin.
That was good.
Right. Or you don't know the origin.
You know where they
came from. These notes. They might mean something.
You said that.
Who do you know? Who have you aggravated that will want to stop Pose?
Wait, why?
I'm saying I think you have an enemy, Sean. Enemies are dangerous.
That's what I'm afraid of.
This isn't real.
Who's your biggest enemy?
I don't know.
Are you talking to Kyle again?
Who?
Are you seeing Kyle again?
This is like a dream, I swear. Wow, dude, that was so scary. That was truly unsettling.
What's this?
I wrote that.
Oh, I nailed it with the dream.
To whom? To whom am I speaking to?
You're using whom, right? Anything?
Murphy's Law.
So I can go back to bed?
Yep.
Alright, we'll see you later.
Good night.
Good morning.
Morning. Thanks.
Wait. What?
Okay, never mind.
Didn't think so.
Jesus. Dude, that's giving me like shiver, I swear. Is it saying stop? Oh, Jesus. Oh. Bro, that is giving me shivers. It's like, okay, that looked like the third warning, or fourth actually, because of the dream. I'm just randomly counting, but that looks like everything's trying to stop him from driving. I don't know. That's what I'm getting.
Yes, sir.
I don't know, yes, he's sir. So normal, man. That would have scared the soul out of me. Just hearing that.
I don't know how much that would cost, so. Yeah. Listen, sir, honestly, I don't feel safe in my house. Well, no, just in my car. Yeah. I could ask. Yeah. Yeah, okay. I mean, they just might be a little annoyed.
Well, sir, until we have an idea who this is or an actual threat is made, there's not much we can do.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Have a good one.
Bye.
God, now what? Another note? Yeah. Dude. Oh, it's like shutting. Oh, wow. The exit. Your mom's name's Harriet. Don't trust death. Oh my God. Don't. That was from his dream. So it's like, I don't even think any of this is happening.
Hi, Sean.
Ready to get your ass kicked into now?
Coming, guys. Yeah, I did call the cops. They basically said they can't do shit.
Of course they can't.
It's always so complicated.
Mm-hmm. But anyway.
Yeah, the dream stuff.
Look at this.
What the fuck?
That's a picture from my dream last night.
How did you do that?
I didn't do that. I found this on my counter.
Real cool.
That's AI.
No, I swear. Like this. No, this is not AI. This is real. I mean, I don't know if it... But this is from my dream, dude.
All right, so it's from your dream, right? But, like, how did you get me...
I'll tell you what, like, fade or something before he tried to show it to him.
Vivid memory from...
But he'd actually show it to him.
Smiling in my dream. You went, pose, this was for my dream.
Must have been pretty fucked up last night.
No, that, you absolutely fucking were.
No,
Uno.
No, wait,
guys,
I
need you to listen to me.
Dude, we're here. We came, and you've been talking about these notes all night. Hey, you want to be distracted from this shit, and although I admit it's a pretty scary situation, just play the fucking game and stop freaking yourself out. Sarah took the picture.
What?
We were drunk.
Reverse. Your turn. Let's go. Come on. Reverse it up.
Where are you going? Fuck.
That is messed up.
Actually, hold on. Stop. Wait,
something happened at that party.
Kyle, stop. No more notes. I just need to see. Have you been writing? I'm not gonna know who wrote it unless I just try.
It's
what? Dude, what the fuck?
What just happened?
You tell me.
It's a psychological.
What's going on?
Who were you just talking to?
Probably Regan.
Who's Kyle?
I don't know.
Don't trust your friends.
Seriously?
Why are you fucking with me?
What, are you fucking with us?
Who wrote that?
Should we literally just watch you write that?
Dude, you literally just fucking wrote that note.
Why are you fucking with me? You know I'm already fucking scared. Why are you fucking with me? Why are you wearing your death costume?
Okay, fine. Kyle wrote it.
What?
You're supposed to die, Sean. You can't do that.
Why are you fucking with me?
I'm not. I'm not.
Fuck.
Huh.
Sean, sit down. Sit down, Sean. Sit down, Sean.
We need to take him back.
You are Sean. You are Sean. No, he needs to hear it.
What do you mean?
Who am I talking to?
What do you mean?
Who is speaking?
You're speaking.
God damn it, Kyle.
It's gotten worse. Listen, we're gonna help.
Dude, are you kidding me?
Listen, we're gonna help you. We're gonna get you help.
People that can help you, they look scary because you make them scary.
No, don't. No.
I need you to come
with me. Stop it.
I need you to come to the street, Kyle.
What are you... No. Whoa.
He's not gonna come with you. He's saying
stop.
Weird.
Stop.
Come
back to the street. Please. Come on. Kendall, please.
Come back to the street.
Come out.
No. Fuck.
There's that voice. Dude, what the heck am I watching? Look at the... The head movement back there.
Sir, this is serious. You need to see this. Watch, go ahead. Come out in the street.
Turn it on.
Hey, this is your neighbor.
Turn it down. Right,
sir, this is serious. You need to see this. Sir, this is serious. You need to see this.
For it to turn, like, the walk thing. Boom. The walk symbol's on. I start crossing the street, and out of nowhere, sharp left turn. This white SUV is going like 70 miles per hour. The tires are making like this horrible noise. I pull like a ninja move to dive like out of the way. I swear I had to like dive. It was like straight out of an action movie. My heart was fucking racing, dude. I cheated death right there. This is just crazy.
Always.
For like every step you take, like you dodge causing.
He's writing the notes. Yeah, like his friend told him.
Near death experience, dude. appreciative. I'm gonna appreciate the fuck out of this part.
There's no way out.
Hold on. Someone left a note on my car.
All right, you guys, there you have it. That is Warnings. All right, so here's from what I understood of this film. Besides it being well performed, it being super disturbing, unsettling at like a lot of scenes, especially like that car scene where you hear this like, you know, moaning, very muffled, you know, background sound of just disturbing type of like audio. That was very unsettling. And like, I was surprised it even was that unsettling in that like nice morning time of the day. I would expect this to be like done at night, but it was just as effective and as scary. But other than everything just being so well done and so well performed, down to like every actor in this short film, I was still kind of having a hard time what was really happening, you know, due to like these dream sequences and very confusing conversations or interactions that they've had at some points. So from what I understood is that this character, Sean, this main character, is actually, well, you know, now at the end, when I saw him actually walk into the car and another like version of himself going to the car and leaving this note that he himself was writing, after all, like we get it at the end here. From what I understood is that he, like his like soul or something was trying to prevent himself from driving a car after like a party that they went to. Driving like drunk or whatever, like getting in a car and driving drunk and like killing himself or I don't know, like him killing somebody else. We get this character that's mentioned a lot named Kyle. So I was like thinking, is Kyle Sean? And then he's just kind of like confusing his identity with somebody else, or is Kyle another person that was a victim of his drunk driving, or was he a victim of Kyle's drunk driving? So I was just a little bit confused on what happened here. But at the end, I get this whole like thing of him trying to stop what was happening. And all these people that were surrounding him weren't really there. They were representing like other people that were in some kind of afterlife kind of thing, or like a dream sequence that just kept going over and over, like on and on and on. Well, the part that felt like more like a dream sequence, you know, not just like apart from the entire film, was where he's sitting in the couch, right? Everything is just happening so randomly. When he's sitting in the couch with his friend, everything is happening randomly. And the way he's screaming as he's watching himself getting like beaten on the ground definitely felt like a very horrific, twisted, like really difficult to understand type of dream sequence. And I love that, how they kept it so relatable to when you have dreams, it's very hard to explain them. And it's very easy to forget them as well. So it's hard to explain to other people. So that's what I felt in that scene. But throughout the whole movie, I still felt like he was not actually there. Like things were just happening, but it was him, like his consciousness or another version of himself or something like that, trying to prevent things from happening or trying to understand what really happened. You know, so I was a little bit confused, but everything that happened from scene to scene was just like very, like I was just engaged in the entire film. You know, it just kept me entertained. And I was trying to figure out what was going on. We get him, or we see him getting all these notes, you know, throughout the film of like, please, I'm begging you to stop. Don't drive your car. Your mom's name was Helen, I believe was the name, or something like that. And then, don't trust death. Don't trust your friends. Like all of these things. And I think that all these notes were happening from him. In the end, of course, we get the whole like reveal of who was writing the notes, which was himself. But all these notes that were happening from him were being written to like prevent something from happening. You know what I mean? Like almost like if he went back in time and he was writing himself these notes, you know, don't trust your friends, don't trust death. And then just him trying to like tell himself something. I can just imagine like if I'm sitting here right now and I'm living my life, you know, and let's just say, I'm definitely unconscious that something just happened to me. Okay. I'm going to tell you guys really quick. Like I think back sometimes to when I was in the mountain over in Mexico. I was, you know, this is going to sound so bluntly. I'm just going to put it bluntly, but I'm surprised nothing happened to me. You know, I was in a very dangerous area where there's lots of animals that can kill you. And there's lots of bad people up there that, you know, live in those areas and take control of those areas. So I was just walking by myself up there And when I got back down, you know, like everything happened during the day. I got back down to like the town and back to my family. And at night, I couldn't believe I was back into like a room, into a bed. And I actually made it. You know, I was even like jumpy for like 2 days straight. I was a little jumpy and couldn't believe I was back there. And I think about like if I were, you know, if this were the reality that I actually did not come back, and then there was somebody trying to tell me like, don't climb the mountain. You know, don't go up there by yourself. You know, don't trust, don't trust your uncle, or don't trust people that are telling you that they're going to take you up there and things like that, because this is all stuff that was happening to me. And this is stuff that I did on my own. I made that decision to go up there, but you know, thank God I made it back. Clearly it wasn't my time to die in this planet. It wasn't my time to go, is what I think. And I'm just thinking like, if that were the reality, you know, if I can compare this or relate that situation to this movie, I would think, or the short film, I would think about like myself telling my future self or my past self or whatever to not do what I'm gonna do. And this is what I was thinking that was happening throughout this movie, you know, himself keeping his other self from having an accident or causing an accident or killing somebody. Again, this character named Kyle, I think he was somebody that he killed or he killed him, or, you know, all of that stuff. But in the end, we see this man knocking on the door behind Sean. And as Sean is watching this very unsettling, creepy perform, I mean, the performances were just amazing. Like, I think he was just seeing a silhouette of himself back in the, like, you know, in the background over there in the distance. I don't know who that was. Was it Kyle, or was it Sean, or was it another person? But he was seeing this like silhouette of himself making these weird, like, twisty motions on his neck like this. It was just so disturbing. And then we get the friend dancing around in a very unsettling, unnatural way, with the mask of the Momo character. And all of that was just super well done. And as he's staring at them, there's somebody behind him knocking. So it's almost like somebody behind him is like warning him, is telling him, like, is begging him to please go outside. This is what I was like. See, this was hard to understand for him, but this is things that were trying to like keep him from doing what he did, you know, from going back in time, or from going into another realm, preventing himself from doing something else. Like, this was another person trying to tell him not to do all of that. I don't know. It was just all really weird. So what I did was I finally went down to the comment section, and I had to read people's like replies and see what they thought. I read this really long reply of somebody that seems like they nailed it to, you know, to figure out what was actually being explained. And it turns out that Kyle was somebody that he killed after the party, after he drove drunk. So I was kind of close to what was happening there, but I didn't understand which direction to take it to so that I can be like, have a firm idea of what happened. So this person was saying that Kyle was a victim of his, and after the party he drove drunk and killed this person. So this whole time he's like trying to, like, another person that's himself, or he himself again, is trying to go back in time, like kind of loop it around again and prevent himself from getting in that car after the party and killing somebody, you know. But what's confusing me at the beginning is that we get this character Sean walking up to his car and talking about how he jumped from a car, like running him over, you know, like he himself was like, oh man, I did like a ninja movement or whatever, a ninja move, and I totally like survived that. It was crazy. Yeah, like that was I can't even think right now, a near-death experience. You know, he tells his friend on the phone, and all of a sudden he sees the note, and that note, of course, comes from himself. So all this kind of confused me. Let me know if, I hope I didn't confuse you guys. I know I'm just kind of a little bit all over the place here, but I was also trying to figure things out on my own. Let me know what you guys thought, though, down below in the comment section, and explain to me what you thought and what you understood. And if I missed something, or if I was also wrong about that, the comment I read of the person that I thought had to figure it out, let me know what you understood. You know, simple as that. Just let me know what you understood. And also, what did you think about this? You guys, this was 100% horrific, unsettling, disturbing, and very psychological thriller type of film. You know, I definitely felt that. Definitely reminds me to, you know, back in, if I think about Shutter Island with Leonardo DiCaprio. I don't know if you guys have seen that, but with Shutter Island featuring Leonardo DiCaprio, that was a film that's very relatable, to where he's doing all these things throughout the film, but he's not there anymore. You know what I mean? Like, he's really just, like, it's just something messing with his mind. He's kind of crazy. You know, he's like a person that keeps repeating the same thing over and over again. But it's just like all of this psychological stuff, it really messes with your head at the end. So in that film, it's very relatable to this, what happened here. And so I really appreciate this type of filmmaking because it is very difficult to explain and it's very difficult to accomplish. So, I mean, I was still confused after this to an extent. But I feel like I figured most of it out. Other than that, you guys, I love the horror aspect of this. I love the sound designs. I love the unnatural movements that were happening in here and the really creepy, confusing conversations that were also happening here. Definitely added to the horror in this film. But yeah, you guys, those are my thoughts. That's what I try to figure out here. Let me know again what you thought down below. And thank you so much for watching with me. I hope you guys stuck this long with me all throughout the video. I know it took a while, but thank you, you guys. I appreciate it. And I hope you guys have a great day. Take care of yourselves.